At the time, I was working the front desk, so I was the counter clerk.
So you're the one who received the One Hong Kim application?
Yes.
Okay. But you weren't doing the data capture at that point. It was...
No.
Mr. Robinson?
Yes.
Okay. Do you recall receiving this passport application?
Yes.
Who did you receive it from?
Minister Pena.
Okay. Did he bring only this one to you?
That day, yes.
Okay. On that day? Okay. And what, if anything, did he say to you did he say anything to you?
I can't recall that we had any conversation, but normally they would just present the application. And if they would get it expedited, then they would either talk to the supervisor or the counter supervisor.
So, but, Chairman, I'm having difficulty.
Yeah, can you speak up,
sorry,
please?
Pull it.
Yeah, just pull it. Mm-hmm. Ordinarily, you would have to get... You would get the application form from the applicant, right?
Yes.
But this one, Mr. Penner brought it.
Ordinarily, it states that the person should present him or herself to the office.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So it doesn't necessarily mean you have to hand you the application, him or herself, as long as they're at the office.
But who would they hand it to?
Sorry?
Who would they hand it to?
The applicant?
Yes. If not to the person, clerk.
The person at the front desk.
That's right. So the person has to deliver it to the counter clerk, right?
Yes.
Right. It has to be in person.
Like I said, the applicant has to present him or herself to the office. But what I'm saying is that if you're applying, it doesn't necessarily mean you hand me your paper. If you're with somebody that's doing the transaction on your behalf and you're right there, then
okay, I understand.
That's what I mean.
Mm-hmm. So yes, I understand that, you know, your agents, a lot of, you call them consultants.
If agents is the right term, then...
No. Yeah. I'm not saying that's the right term. I'm just saying that I understand what you mean now. There were a lot of people who were doing things on behalf of others.
Yes.
But they were there, but all right, fine. In this case, it was Minister Penner.
Yes.
Did you see the person who he was with, the applicant?
Yes.
So the applicant was there. How was he dressed? Do you recall?
I don't recall exactly what he had on, like a suit. I don't recall the exact suit or how to describe it.
Was the application complete? The application that you received from Minister Penner?
It was.
So it had the required passport photos?
Yes.
Did you see anything peculiar or out of the ordinary with this particular application?
The only thing that would have been out of the ordinary would have been the spelling of the name, K-I-N instead of K-I-M. But like we made mention in the report was that when we process our passport application, we use the source document or the original document, because there are plenty of people that make mistakes on their form, and before we tell them to, you know what, fill out the next form and go find our next GAP, we don't pay much attention to what they write. Because what we use when we create the passport is the original birth paper, the original nationality, or the original expired passport, which would have on the correct spelling of the name.